My name is Guy Russell. They call me Weddle. I'm the owner and builder of Final Judgment. Final Judgment is a 1964 Chevy Impala Super Sport that is fully custom all the way from ground up and interior exterior. The murals on Final Judgment, the artwork represents exactly like what Michelangelo did on the Sistine Chapel. The headliner itself has many colorful images. It was basically on a rotisserie flip upside down to enable to put the whole entire artwork of Michelangelo on the headliner. So everything was done on the inside first. Everything was stenciled by Shinji. Took him about a month, every day, about maybe 12 hours a day, because he had to change colors from one color to another color, another color, another color, just to get one picture frame. So if you look at the headliner, there's many picture frames. If you look, it's not simple. It's not a two-tone color mural. It's different colors, from reds to skin color to blues to greens to browns. Same thing with the trunk. The trunk has Final Judgment behind the altar of the Sistine Chapel. Took them about a good month to do the trunk. You see all the angels, all the spirits from very detailed. You take a look at all that, it's so much work. If you look at on the end of the trunk, where the trunk closes on the sides, there is the serpent, the devil, and God on one side, which he did that here in San Diego. He did the hood, which took him about another month and a half. The hood itself, if you look at it, it's a lot of work. Small little angels that you can't even see. They're so small in detail that you don't even think it's there, but it's there. But if you look at it really close, you'll see little angels. Concrete walls, you see little angels, little figures. The clouds are all made out of angels if you look at it. So it's very, very detailed. If you look at the custom bezel that I did on the dash, you had Virgin Mary holding Jesus Christ. Then you also see is those billet door seals that I custom made that has Final Judgment on the sides that lights up with LED. Those are also muraled out. If you look at the bottom of the suspension, I made a panel, and I'll also put a mural there that Shinji did, which is the Last Supper. So if you look at it under a mirror at a show, you'll see the Last Supper. Shinji counted all the faces that he did. It was 200, and I think it was like 80 something faces. There's more other stuff that I am doing that it's not out, not done yet, which is gonna be more murals. That will come into a later date. I use Sal Manzano for all my resin paint job, which I've always wanted a paint job from him. And I always said, I'm gonna get somebody to paint my car and it's gonna be Sal. Using his patterns that he normally uses, which is if you see the Z's, and that you know that's Sal.
My name is Sal Manzano, and I'm the painter of Final Judgment. I actually took over, I say over 3,000 hours worth of working on it, and I got asked that on this car. How did you come up with all those colors and stuff? You know, it's just, you see it in a rainbow. All the colors blend. You just gotta know where to put it at. The difference about a resin flake and a regular clear flake and urethane clear or lacquer clear is a different chemical. The flake is always gonna sit down. It's never gonna float or nothing because it's different materials. The reason why the flake works on resin, because it's the same thing. Flake is made out of fiberglass resin. So when you combine a liquid resin and a flake material, which is made out of the same product, it's gonna bind. So it's gonna be one. So when you spray it, it lays out better, it flows out better, it sticks better, it shows more, and it's just gonna give you that flatness pop out of it. And that's the difference between a urethane flake compared to a resin flake.
Quite a few times, he put some strikes and I said, you know, Sal, I think we should put some more, right, Sal? And, or we should do a cross on the top. He knew my vision because right after I tell him that, he's like, okay, I know what I'm gonna do. I
always wanted to do a cross as a pattern. And when he told me, hey, can you do a cross? I was like, in my mind, I was like, wow, I finally get to do a cross, you know? Because you don't see this type of theme on lowriders. It's all about girls and payasos and cruising, which is nothing wrong with it, right? You're blessed to do that. You're blessed to go out there and show your car and have that life. But you gotta always thank God for what you have. The second thing on this car is the striping and leafing. And we brought in Jonathan Mercado, pinstriping. And he's a very talented young kid. I knew that it would be right for him to work on this car because he has that talent of style that I have, you know? And when you have someone that kind of knows your style and kind of knows how your work is, then it's like, you know, like one person working on it, not just two. But at the end of the day, he did what his mind told him to. You know what I mean? Because that's what an artist is. And it's great to create something like this, you know, for people all over the world to see. I'm sure this car has been seen all over the world already. Because I've gotten calls from people from all over the world, you know, Japan, Australia. I mean, there's lowriders everywhere now. And this sort of is a flagship right now. People know this car, you know, which is cool. And, you know, and I'm part of it, and that's amazing. And I think I did nice. I mean, I've gotten very good response on this car. This car, I mean, look at it. I mean, it is a work of art.
The inspiration that got me to do a full custom car and honor my mother, where I grew up in gang violence and not listening to my mother. She would cry, don't go out on the streets. It took me, after my mom passed away, to realize the meaning of everything, of life. It changed my ways of being the person who I was, to show the world, my family, what it's about. I'm not the perfect man, but we can all make a change. I changed a lot to where I was, from bad to good. You know, the murals itself explains it all. There's only one person that judges, and that is God. The front of the grill, it's all one piece. Had that one done by Mario from Elite. He's the one that did that. All my grills, the license plate grill, the front and back and trunk. Those bumpers are also one piece. Where the wipers go, basically it's shaved. That's all water jet to Majestics. The hood molding, it says Final Judgment on there, and it's water jet as well. That lights up, that's with LED as well. And the trunk emblem as well has the emblem water jet. I don't have a gas tank on the bottom, if you notice. The gas tank is in the trunk. It's like a fuel cell. I had that special made, and it holds the same amount of fuel what your normal gas tank has on an Impala. And these are things that, you know, you look at and you see how can you build something different? Something that you don't really see as much out there. You gotta be creative. It's called artwork. You go to different shows, you look, observe other people's, you admire other people's cars, and you're like, wow, it's amazing. What can I do different? So I decided to come up with something different. I did those King Digit handles. I shaved my gas tank lid. I modified the molding. If you notice, it's a one-piece molding now. It's not a three-piece molding, so I ended up modifying that molding to make it into one big piece that contours to the quarter panels. The other modifications I have in the interior is the visors, which they're water jet, they're custom made. Decided to do that route because I wanted to stand out a little bit different. I actually have LEDs on those as my car club where I'm from. So, you know, let people recognize what car club is this, you know? The headliner, I have that as a one piece molded headliner out of steel welded. So I have a molded glove box. So there's no glove box there. All the interior, it's all modified to four bucket seats, the Thunderbird seats in the front, and then the custom bucket seats that I did in the back, center console, all the way through with all power push button ignition. There are no keys, Dakota digital dash, which I can change whatever color I want in the whole entire dash. Some panels that I did for engraving and underneath with some leafing and some painting that I did, and also added some murals in the bottom as well on the floor pans of the interior. The sunroof is a 44-inch sunroof. Very rare that people have 44-inch sunroof. 44-inch sunroof is very hard to get, and they're not common. Some people think that it couldn't fit on a 64, you know, and the bigger the better. And that's also incorporated with the whole entire headliner, which is a lot of work because you have to make sure everything fits. The hydraulics of the car, we sat down and we discussed what can we do to go with the thing. Making some crosses out of a tank. One was for my mother and one for my grandmother. Rest in peace. Those oil tanks feeds four hydraulic pumps. There's two in the trunk and two underneath the car. The slowdowns are not just regular valves. They're crosses. So it kind of stands out a little bit different. The plate for the hydraulics to sit on, so it's easy access, pull in and pull out, you know. There's four batteries to the hydraulics. The painting of the pumps and stuff like that, if you look at the board, the bottom was all done by Sal. One of the biggest modifications I did in Final Judgment is all the LED lights throughout the whole entire car. The headlights are halos, LEDs. Also, the front hood molding has Final Judgment, that lights up. Trunk LED, which is a trunk emblem, has also LEDs. I can change it to whatever color I want throughout the whole car. All remote Bluetooth controlled by a phone. On the visors, which says Majestics, that also has LEDs, where my windshield wipers used to be at one point. It's all shaved, and it's also water jet with LED. The tail lights are also LEDs, but also with halos. I think I was the first car that had halos on the tail lights, which I can change whatever color on the tail lights to whatever color I want. If you look at the suspension, I have custom A-arms, control A-arms on the bottom, extended A-arms on the top. They're all molded. They're not made from a 64 and then molded over that. It was all custom. We basically template and make our own A-arms, top and bottom. When I got the car originally, it had power steering. Usually all the power steering on Chevys, they always end up leaking from the bottom. Next you know, you got it all underneath your car. Kind of avoided that, and I went with a rack and pinion from a Camaro. And if you look at the actual boots on the rack and pinion, they're custom. I had them made a custom red color. The actual bracket for the rack and pinion is all engraved in chrome. The rack and pinion itself is chrome with all the tie rods engraved. The brakes are all disc brakes, front and back. All the calipers are engraved. All the lines are custom. All the exhausts from the engine, from the front to the back, all Flowmaster, all engraved in chrome. Little stuff, little details that I decided to do, use a certain bushings, certain type of bolts that I used to kind of dress up the bottom of it. I did a lot of the covers. If you look at the engine bay going towards the bottom of the belly, you'll see all the body mounts. I have covers for those. You know, it's all chromed out, made piece or engraved to cover those body mounts and the washers. Stuff that you shouldn't really see, you know, it kind of dresses it up a little bit. Towards the back, you have the trailing arms, which is all extended and chrome and engraved. I have a Toyota rear end with the wishbone, reinforced and engraved. Trunk pan that's engraved in chrome. Final Judgment has an LS1 engine, which same thing as a 350, but just a newer version. I crank this car on, turn it on with no problem. The engine itself has a lot of billet specialty pulleys, which is all engraved. Another feature of the motor, which I fabricated and built, is the engine cover to enhance the engine compartment, make it look better. If you look at the fenders, I integrated an inner fender. I had another set of 64 Impala fenders and I molded them on the inside. So if you look at a right fender, I put it into a left side on the inside. and put the left into the right side, you know. I created the idea just to make it look different. I use Sal Manzano for all my resin paint job. Sal is a legendary, respectful, hats off to him. Mercado, Jonathan, which did all the striping, that collaborated with him. Mike David did all the framework, the undercarriage. He painted all the belly prior before Sal Manzano painted the body. And Shinji, we all call him Pancho. He did all the Final Judgment murals. Lindsay, auto upholstery, which he used all leather, incorporated the moldings and try to work things out with the push button thing and all that stuff with the center console. Pancho did all my wiring throughout the whole car. I used three different engravers because I had work going out everywhere and I wanted to make sure it got done. Everybody followed the same pattern. I had Speedy's engraving, Swing's engraving up in Arizona, which he's the one that first started. He did most of my undercarriage. And then I had Alex Artisan engraving. All that engraving chrome came from them, so hats off to them. STR, he did my hydraulic setup. Said a big thanks to my wife, Marisol. Without her, I'm saying, it would be more difficult for me because imagine a man putting all the money into a car. A lot of women won't allow that for their man or husband to do that. And she wants to get a car so we can ride together. I was telling Sal, I think we're gonna do another car, let's do it. We might get up more projects for our kids, let them have a car, and build a community. I want to give thanks to my family for supporting me on everything I do with low riding because they all support what I do, so that's what I'm grateful for. God's plan, God's plan. I hold back sometimes I won't, yeah. I feel good sometimes I don't, hey. Finesse down Western Road, hey, next. Might go down to G-O-D, yeah, wait. I go hard on Southside G, yeah, wait. I make sure that Northside E. And still, God's plan. I can't do this on my own, hey, no. Hey. Someone watching it close, yeah, close. I've been me since Scarlet Road, hey. God's plan. Might go down as G-O-D. I can't do this on my own. I go hard on Southside G. Someone watching it close. I make sure that Northside E. Yeah. And still.